tonight as Jim Hrickett gets the call for his first start in the National Hockey League. Skruglund leans in against Pavonka. Pavonka gets the draw. The game's underway. Langway plays the puck and right away gets some applause from the crowd. Here's a hit by Leach as he piles into Chris Chelios. Now centered and a great save there with his left hand. Now a fight in front of the net. Sheedy starts to swing in there with, I believe, Claude Lemieux.
That's Lemieux.
And Sheedy getting off some right hand. And Lemieux getting in a couple of punches. Now Sheehy coming in with some uppercuts to the body. And starts to punish Lemieux. Oh, there's a hard shot with the right hand by Sheehy. And the linesman get in and pull them apart.
You see, so showing some of that Harvard boxing experience. You don't see too many NHL fighters use body punches, Mike, but Neil Sheedy saw from Lemieux up a bit late with that body punch. But almost forgotten, this is a brilliant save right there by Jim Rybnak. Max Naslund set up all alone in the slot, and Rybnak kicks out the pads. And here comes the exchange between Lemieux and Sheedy. Some early shots from Lemieux, but then watch Neil Sheedy return, starts working the body, and then really starts to connect to the face of Claude Lemieux. There are the body punches. That sets up a good right cross.
Here are the penalty calls. Sheehy gets 5 for fighting. So does Lemieux, but Lemieux tagged with an additional minor penalty for instigating the fight.
Sheehy continues to try and give it verbally this time to Claude Lemieux. Hatcher was able to tie him up and force McPhee just to kind of one-hand it off, but you see right there, Chelios shoving aside Kalle Johansson, and that soft shot goes right through Rybnak. Now we got a fight here in center ice between Rouse and McPhee.
This one right off the opening faceoff after the goal, and McPhee trying to get a right hand loose. Rouse has got his sweater pulled up over McPhee's head, but it turns into a wrestling match as the linesmen pull them down and keep them apart. Seems to be breathing pretty hard. I did not see the play on which Sheehy was injured, but now he's back to his skates. And it appears as though, oh, now he's telling the referee that he did get an elbow or a glove to the mouth. In fact, he's looking around to see who it was that did it, and he's headed to the Montreal bench to accost whoever it was, and it seemed that the longer time went, the angrier Sheehy got, and now he's picked out another opponent that he wants to talk to, and it looks like this is going to be Todd Ewan.
Well, apparently there's not going to be any penalty calls.
Well, it was very clearly behind the play. As the Caps dumped the puck in, Sheehy was suddenly dropped.
He looks like he's got his eye on somebody on the Montreal bench as well.
I think Ewan just might have been willing to take up the cause, but I don't think it was Ewan that Sheehy's really talking about here.
Well, you see the stick up there from Keane and the slash back from Stephen Leach. Another shot from Keane and then another slash from Leach, and those two just go flying at each other. Well, obviously the initial high stick from Mike Keane was missed.
Here's another fight. And one linesman, Kevin Collins, trying to break it up. Now here comes Gary Pinkman in to help out, and they prevent Ewan and Bruce from ever really throwing any punches. But here we've got Alan May and Ewan starting back out, trying to line up for a faceoff. Alan May and Corson now talk it over, and we may still get some penalties out of this. They hadn't even lined up for the faceoff when Ewan and May started to joust at one another.
Now Ewan is trying to get at Neil Sheehy, and if Todd Ewan was going to stay in the game, he's going to be gone now.
Gary Pateman did a great job of keeping Lemieux out of the altercation. Now Richie and Sheehy are nose to nose, and now Ciccarelli steps in there to talk to Richie. But Lemieux was twisting and turning, trying to get away from the linesman, and Gary Pateman kept him out of the fight, but it won't keep him out of the game. Bruins record now 21 wins, 26 losses, 4 ties. And the Canadians are 25 wins, 20 losses, and 6 ties.